Hey, what's up, y'all? So if you've been following my channel for a while, you'll know that I'm not always the biggest GZI fan. I've ridden 9 of them so far, and for the most part, although I do like their layouts of their rides, I find them a little bit lacking in terms of airtime, as I generally only experience very mild floater air for the most part. So while I've enjoyed rides on coasters like Hershey Park's Lightning Racer and Dollywood's Thunderhead, for the most part, they don't blow me away. The only GCI I've really liked a lot was Mystic Timbers. Well, finally, I'm a believer in what GCI can do. Gold Striker blows away every other GCI I've ridden. It blows it completely out of the water. I loved this ride. So start out with the stats. Gold Striker is 108.2 feet tall. It's 3,197 feet long with a duration of 2.5 minutes and a top speed, according to RCDB, of 53.7 miles per hour. Although I will say it seems much faster to me when you're on the ride. First of all, it is beautifully situated at the front of the park. It's the first thing you see when you go in. They've got a nice plaza there, and naturally we headed straight for it. My first ride was great. It was fast with lots of unexpected twists and turns and solid floater air throughout. However, later in the day when it had warmed up a bit, the ride really got going. My non-enthusiast traveling companion even noticed the significant increase in speed. I was really surprised how much faster it got, and because of that, the floater that I was experiencing on my first few rides really turned into solid floater and mild ejector throughout the course, and that's just the kind of mix I love on a ride. I find most GCIs to be front seat rides, and I'm a solid back seat rider myself, so it was sweet to find a GCI that delivered in the back as well. There are quite a few standout moments on this ride. The first up, of course, is the first drop curling around the observation tower. It's beautiful to look at. It's very picturesque, and it's like a modern reproduction of the infamous Coney Island Tornado's first drop, except much larger, more spread out, and of course there's a tunnel on it. The next sequence of turns is excellent, with plenty of changes in direction and the airtime pops that we expect on a GCI, and there's some good lats sprinkled in there as well. After the midway turn, the train dives down beside the station and continues twisting and banking around the structure, bouncing up and down and solidly confusing riders until the last final turn under the structure onto the brakes. I really like this last final turn too. Just being in the structure is really cool. And every time we hit the final brakes, everyone on our train was giggling and laughing and just blown away by this ride. The only real downsides I noticed were that the ride did go down several times throughout the day, and it's probably getting close to the time when Gold Striker needs retracking. Maybe I would say within 5 years. Right now it's okay. There's some light jackhammering here and there, but it's nothing too awful, and I've certainly been on much rougher woodies. Also, the ride is on the complete other side of the country for me, and I don't really know anyone who lives over there, so there's a little chance I'll return soon, so that's a major downside for me. If somebody wants to go ahead and clone it over here on the East Coast, that'd be great. So with those few small points raised, I'll just repeat that I love this ride. After hitting up all the major parks in Northern California during my recent trip, which also covered Santa Cruz Beach Boardwalk and Six Flags Discovery Kingdom, this was my favorite. Yes, I even liked it more than Railblazer at the same park, but that's a topic for another video. California's Great America is nice too. They've got a nice 1-2-3 punch of good coasters, and then a decent number of supporting rides that really help round out the collection. We were there on a Saturday in early June, and it wasn't too crowded either, which is always great. And the weather in Northern California seems to be uniformly pretty nice year-round, so the park definitely has that going for it as well. So yeah, finally found the GCI that I love. Mystic Timbers came close for me, but Gold Striker definitely blew that ride away. What about you, though? If you've ridden Gold Striker and think it's great, let me hear about it. Or if you think I'm full of shit, let me hear about that, too. Just leave a comment below. Otherwise, I'll talk to you next time. Take care and enjoy the ride.